Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel Life Science with KMD. Today I am going to explain about cosmids and its types. Cosmid is a plasmid containing one or two copies of coccyte of bacteriophage lambda. It is useful as a vector for gene cloning in conjugation with packaging system. The concatemers of cosmid molecule linked at their coccyte act as a substrate for in vitro packaging. The host containing cosmid do not form plaques but form a colonies. Cosmid have insert capacity, high insert capacity, that is about 30 to 45 kb. They are often used as a cloning vector in genetic engineering. Cosmid can be used to build genomic libraries. They were first discovered by Collins and Horns in 1978. Cosmid can contain 37 to 52 normally 45 kb of DNA limits based on the normal bacteriophage packaging size. They can replicate as plasmid if they have a suitable origin of replication. For example, SV40 origin site in mammalian cell line and call E1 origin for double-stranded DNA replication and F1 origin site for the single-stranded DNA replication in prokaryotes. They frequently also contain a gene for selection such as antibiotic resistance so that the transformed cells can be identified by plating on medium containing antibiotics. Those cells which did not take up the cosmid would be unable to grow. Unlike plasmid, they can also be packaged in phage capsid, which allow the foreign gene to be transformed into or between the cells of transduction. Plasmid become unstable after certain amount of DNA has been inserted into them because their increased size is more conducive to recombination. To circumvent this, phage transduction is used instead. This method possible by cohesive end, also known as coccyte. In this way, they are similar to using the lambda phage as a vector, except all the lambda phage genes have been deleted with the exception of cos sequence. Now, there are two types of cosmid. One is single cos cosmid. Example is PGB8, which consists of a single cos site. Another one is dual cos cosmid, which consists of two cos site. Along with it, it has a cos recognition sequence on both the cos sites. Example are C2XB or supercos1, PLFR5. In case of supercos1 is a novel 7.9 kb cosmid vector that contain bacteriophage promoter and promoter sequence flanking in a unique cloning site. This structure allow rapid synthesis of walking probe specific for extreme end of insert DNA. The cos1 vector is also engineered to contain genes for the amplification and expression of cosmid clones in eukaryotes. Cloning capacity of 30 to 42 kb. For generating cosmid library, it can be used for generating cosmid library. Ideal for high resolution restriction mapping and rapid chromosomal walking. In case of a PGB8, which is a single cosmid, is a circular plasmid, do not occur naturally. Origin of replication sequence for E. coli is present. selectable marker like ampicillin resistance and restriction site for the cloning of gene of our interest is also present in this vector. It contain phage lambda cos site which permit package into lambda phage head and therefore introduce to E. coli cells. Packaging only occur with 37 to 72 kb fragment, selection for large fragment. Packaged DNA is inserted into cell and then replicated as a very large plasmid. Advantages of cosmids: can be used in gene cloning vector. Cosmid are high insert capacity vector and they are used for the analysis of complex genome. Large gene can be studied intact and genetic linkage study can be carried out at molecular level. Background molecule which do not have their insert DNA or have a smaller insert are eliminated during packaging. Transformation frequency of cosmid is high. Thanks for watching my video. Please subscribe to my channel by clicking on subscription button. Subscription doesn't cost you any money. To get a notification, click on a bell icon. Do like and share this video with friends and family. If you have any kind of feedback, do share it on a comment box. Thank you.